Hi all, this is Ilish, and I'm reviewing a game against AngelZuniga in the Spicee Tour. I go second, and the first thing I look at the board are the trade cards. So the most powerful trade card is the 2 brown to 3 green, 1 red, 1 yellow, and we have a bunch of straight up produce cards, and also a mass red producer and the red rainbow card, which kind of form a combo. Not a very strong one, but it's still playable. Okay, so AngelZuniga goes ahead and takes the red rainbow card, and I'm not too worried about that two-card combo, so I just take the yellow that's offered along with the yellow producer card, and that will give me a lot of options when going forward. Then he takes the other half of the combo. Now, I'm guessing that he likes the two red producer card, and I like the two brown to three green, one red, one yellow card. So I'm just going to make some cubes and let him take the two red, so I don't have to give up a yellow. Okay, now some more cards are coming in. So the brown to three red, and the three red to three green, and those are powerful cards, and they will upgrade his combo if he takes them, but at the cost of a serious tempo disadvantage, because he has to give up more yellows. So he does, and now I take the brown producer card, because it's a decent card, it can come in handy, and I'm also getting his yellow cube, and he has used his last cube. So at this point, he's out of cubes. He cannot interfere with what I want to do next. So he takes a produce card, and now I can take the mass brown producer. And after he produces, I can also take a mass yellow producer. So altogether, that should be fine, because I can set myself up to four browns, then from there I can produce a lot of greens and some reds and yellows, spend those, and then reset to a lot of greens and yellows and go back to browns. Okay, so I also have the three yellow to one brown trade card, which is not a very powerful card, but it will help me starting up fast here. I have to be careful, because in the three coin slot there is a small card followed by an expensive card followed by further small cards. So in such a situation, I look to be the first to take a three coin. So I set myself up, and he also sets himself up, but I'm faster. And he took one more trade card that aims at setting up the cost for the 18 card. Meanwhile, I can just proceed. Now, normally, if I'm close, I would usually prefer to do the brown producer card three times, but there's no easy way to reset to there, so I will just go on and use it twice. Meanwhile, he has assembled the cost for the 18 card. But he's not buying yet, so he wants to proceed. I really want him to take that, so let's force him. Now, the thing with this is that if he doesn't take, then I will, and he will have a hard time resetting to the 6-point card. He will actually have to downgrade. I'm betting that he doesn't do that, so he just takes the 18, but now his stack of cubes is rather low. So I can set up for the 6-point card in several ways. The red-yellow producer is basically weaker than the green to mass yellow producer, so I'm using that one because it's enough. And meanwhile, he is restarting his engine, and I take the 6 card, and at this point, he basically faces a similar choice. He can take the 12-point card now, but that will leave him with a completely empty stack of cubes, and it will be very slow to start up from there. So I'm guessing that he will just proceed, which he does. And now I can swoop in, take the third 3 coin, and proceed from there. I'm throwing away the reds because I'm looking to reset to 6 yellows, 3 greens after buying. And this way I can do that in one step. So he's also buying, but without a 3 coin at this point. So I'm resetting to 6 browns. I also have one leftover red, which I look to put to good use. So now I'm set up for the 16 point card. Actually, I could take either the 16 or the 12. I don't think it makes much difference, so I'm taking the 16. And I already have 4 cards, so this is the end game. And I'm unsure of his plans, so I make a kind of a waiting move. Just produce some reds and yellows. And he buys the 12 point card. And now his stack of cubes is fairly low, but he can still buy the 9 point card. But if he does, he will be almost completely empty. So let's force him to do that. Now, the way to force someone to buy that card is to set up the cost for that card and one more card, at which point I'm threatening to buy 2 cards and finishing the game. So I cannot do that in one step, but I can do it in 2 steps. Meanwhile, he keeps producing. But at this point, I'm set up to take the 9 card plus the 12 card. So he has to buy the 9, otherwise I will just take both cards without a chance to interfere. And now my main goal is to buy 2 cards without him buying anything else. So I look to close him out, and I'm fairly sure that I will need to go up to 4 browns, but also sure that after that I will need to come back down to reds and greens. So the step order matters a little bit. Usually it would be better to make a move before picking up, but here this is sort of a waiting move. I want to see what his plans are. So he produces 2 reds. So now I go up, and okay, so basically at this point, with one more move, he can only set up the 13 card at this point. So if I reset to the 13 plus one more card, then I should be good. So I'm doing that. I can buy the 13 and the 12 now. And he set up the cost for the 13, but it's too late. And at this point, there's nothing he can do. And I managed to close him out with a lot of cubes still in his stack. Okay, so that was it. The main points in this game were tempo advantage, especially when there's a small card at the 3 coin slot. And that helped me buy 3 of the 3 coins. And in the end game, I was looking to close him out by setting up the cost for 2 cards and then buying without letting him buy anything else. Also, there were several points in the game where I was forcing him, also with a 3 coin and in the end game as well. So that's it. I hope you liked it. Till next time.